Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Chris Lorenc. I serve as president of the Manitoba Heavy Construction Association, and I'm also a member and past chair of the board of directors of CentrePort Canada. It is my great honor this morning to act as MC for this very important announcement. I'm pleased this morning to be able to welcome Premier Stefanson, her colleague ministers Cullen and Pinyuk, the local MLA Ralph Eichler, Winnipeg City Councillor Scott Gillingham, Janice Lukes, distinguished guests from the business community and media. I also do want to pay particular attention and ask you to acknowledge the presence of Patricia Steele and Alana Steele. Patricia is the widow of Morris Steele, who is a genius, an investor way ahead of his time, and who began the process of land assembly upon which the CentrePort lands today sit. So as an acknowledgement to Mrs. Steele and Morris, a round of applause, please. Without any further delay, it is my great privilege to welcome to the podium someone who needs no introduction, either in these or national circles, the Premier of our province and the current Chair of the Premier's Council of the Federation, the Honourable Heather Stefanson.
Thanks, Chris, and good morning, everyone. Great to be here on this beautiful and crisp Manitoba morning. As soon as I took office, I made it clear that our government is keen to collaborate with all levels of government, business, and industry to advance key infrastructure projects that will improve Manitoba's quality of life, create jobs, spur economic growth, and development, and provide hope and opportunity for the future, and that's why we're here today. I'm proud to say that since becoming Premier, our government has moved quickly to advance and provide historic investments to support significant public transit upgrades for the City of Winnipeg, Phase 2 of the North End Wastewater Treatment Plant, and the Arctic Gateway Group, and strategic opportunities for the Port of Churchill, among other things. All of these projects support the growth of our communities, city, and province. And that is what brings us here today. CentrePort is a key economic driver that will continue to create the ongoing investment and high-paying jobs essential for Winnipeg and for all Manitobans. An estimated $60 million is needed for servicing infrastructure to support the expansion and future development of CentrePort South. The City of Winnipeg has committed $20 million. Our government has already committed $20 million. And despite extensive provincial engagement, the federal government has yet to come to support this project, but we continue to urge the federal government to make an equal contribution to this very critical project. This project must move forward without delay, which is why we're here today. And I'm pleased to confirm that if necessary, our government will provide up to $40 million toward the total project cost. Our government is pleased to provide much needed certainty to the City of Winnipeg on this strategic infrastructure priority. This project will create thousands of jobs and drive investment and will put Manitoba on the world map as transportation and trade hub in North America. Future expansion of CentrePort South will increase Manitoba's GDP by almost $1 billion, and it will provide homes for roughly 12,000 people. This project is a win-win-win and a no-brainer. I want this announcement to be a clear signal. Manitoba is open for business, and our government is taking concrete actions to make Manitoba more competitive and a more attractive place for new businesses to start, for existing businesses to grow, and for other businesses to invest right here in this great province of ours. Thank you so much. You can see how important this project is by the sheer number of people that are here today. Thank you to each and every one of you for being here. You are our future. Thank you. This is going to be a great project for Manitoba. There we go.
Thank you very much, Premier, for not just the inspiring message, but the bold forward direction that this announcement is accompanying this morning. So thank you very, very much. It's now my pleasure to invite to the podium Martin McGarry, who serves as President and CEO of MMI Asset Management. Martin continues to pioneer investment in this province through strategic relationships with investors that come to this province to invest in the economy in Manitoba. He serves on a number of boards of directors, including a number of task forces whose mandates are to recommend policies that help grow the economy. He has an intimate knowledge of CentrePort and has been a big part of its success. Ladies and gentlemen, Martin McGarry.
I missed the jacket memo.
You and me both.
Yeah, I'll try to be brief, but I have been waiting, I won't tell you how many years, but many, many years for this opportunity. It's an extremely exciting day. So thank you, Chris Lorenc. Thank you, Premier Stefanson. My name is Martin McGarry. I'm the President and CEO of Cushman Wakefield Stevenson and also MMI Asset Management. You're standing here witnessing what sewer and water and working together can bring. This is phase two of Steel Business Park. If I do say so, one of the most gorgeous buildings I've ever seen. I am thrilled to be here today in CentrePort, standing in front of our development at Steel Business Park, and to hear firsthand that Premier Stefanson and her government are stepping up with $40 million to complete the funding for CentrePort South. Truly a very exciting day for every Manitoban. I can't tell you how long I've waited for this day, but it has been more years than I care to admit. Those of you who know me know that I've been relentless in my pursuit of servicing of CentrePort South. Those pesky pipes will get into the ground in the very near future. It is a bittersweet day today for me personally, however, as my longtime friend and co-developer, Morris Steele, is not here to celebrate with us, but his family members are. Sadly, Morris passed away on July 9th of this year. The name Morris Steele has special meaning to all of us at Cushman Wakefield and MMI. He will be dearly missed. Morris worked tirelessly for decades to get his family lands to market condition. There were many ups and downs along the way, but Morris always persevered. The Steele family has an additional 650 acres in CentrePort South, and now with this announcement, that land can come to fruition. The Steele name will live on in the legacy of CentrePort Canada for many generations to come. Today's announcement is nothing short of monumental for CentrePort, for the city of Winnipeg, and the province of Manitoba. This $40 million investment announced here today by Premier Stefanson will build on already massive success of CentrePort in the arm of Rosser, and now that success will spill over to CentrePort South in the city of Winnipeg. There are some 3,000 acres to be developed in the city of Winnipeg side of CentrePort, including 500 acres of residential land representing well over $1 billion of construction. Premier Stefanson, we applaud you and your team for pushing forward and making this bold announcement. No other provincial government before you has been able to land the plane on servicing of CentrePort South. You listened, you understood, and you executed. We can get shit done now. This investment in CentrePort South will create thousands of jobs and will bind CentrePort North and CentrePort South together in one powerhouse economic development zone known simply now as CentrePort. There is no more CentrePort North, CentrePort South, one CentrePort. There are so many people to thank for getting us here today, and I see one of them staring at me right now wondering if I'm going to say something, but Scott Gillingham has been incredibly instrumental at getting the city's $20 million well over a year ago into this year's city budget. Thank you, Scott. Dana Spiring and Ryan Kuffner from Economic Development in Winnipeg, thank you for all your massive efforts on this file. Know that you now have limitless inventory of shovel-ready land, so you better bring the new businesses here. To my dear friend Diane Gray, words cannot describe the impact you have made on me and our province. and we hope your next adventure will be equally as rewarding. Lastly, I just want to say a few more words about Heather. I was not paid for this, but I just think this was a incredible feat. Today we are celebrating the funding commitment to the servicing of CentrePort South that will lead to massive economic prosperity for all of us. Economic development is the lifeblood for moving our province forward. We can now boast more than ever before, we get done. It is Manitoba's time, it is Winnipeg's time on the Canadian and world stage. We are ready for growth, we are open for business, and we all need to work together, city, province, and the RMs. Thank you, Premier Stefanson, once again for your announcement today. You've truly impacted all of us here. Bravo and congratulations.
Thanks, Mark. Thanks a lot.
Martin, you stole a lot of what I was about to say.
But you can say get shit done.
But I can say it again, and I can throw in that technical word that seemed to elude you. I also want to publicly acknowledge and thank Scott Gillingham. There's been a whole pile of us who've been working on this file, and Scott, without question, has been the CentrePort champion at City Council, and I really appreciate Scott all the time and the political capital that you have invested to make this day happen. So thank you very much, Scott. Let me, I have the microphone, so I can't leave it without saying a few words.
We're freezing here,
okay.
Chris.
I know you're freezing. I've listened to you, Martin, now it's my turn. I need to say, because it's true, that since taking office, Premier Stefanson has made very clear her ambition to move Manitoba's economic fortunes forward for the benefit of Manitobans. And those decisions include, and some of them Martin referred to, reestablishing the Ministry of Economic Development, Investment and Trade, led by Minister Cliff Cullen, who's also Deputy Premier, energizing Manitoba Transportation and Infrastructure Ministry to be an economic growth enabler led by the Honorable Doyle Pinyuk, establishing and chairing the Economic Development Board of Cabinet, resourcing the development and implementation of economic growth policies with a secretariat led by Michael Swiston, establishing the parameters of a provincial venture capital fund to enable leveraged private sector investment in Manitoba's growth led by Mike Pyle, establishing a competitiveness review panel led by Kurt Vossen, to which a working group will submit recommendations on ways and means to improve the competitiveness of Manitoba's tax code, supporting increased wages for workers through the improvement to the basic minimum wage and updating the construction industry wages, minimum wages, committing with the federal government to a joint $75 million investment to improve rail service to the Port of Churchill, which will not only help Manitoba's northern economy, but help establish Manitoba's global trade profile. Noting when she was appointed chair of the Council of the Federation of the critical importance of investing in trade-enabling infrastructure as part of the national discussion, culminating with today's $60 million announcement to extend sewer and water into CentrePort 1, not south. That's the context. This is the context in which the announcement is made today. It is part of a visible and deliberate strategy of our Premier to move Manitoba, Winnipeg, and the Capital Region from the middle of the pack to the head of the pack. I sincerely thank Premier Stefanson for your leadership, for your vision, for getting blank done. Ladies and gentlemen, I understand that Premier Stefanson and Martin will be available for questions. I'm done. I'm out of here. The microphone is done. Good morning.
You have a jacket.